Hello, Aquarius. This is your new moon in Aries card reading. So new moons are a time of setting intentions, planting seeds, new cycle, new beginnings. And Aries is a sign of independence, assertiveness. They like to be the leader. They like being in charge. Aquarius is very much about independence and freedom, but maybe not so much like leading a group of people. Like that's not really our thing as Aquariuses. I'm an Aquarius moon, and I kind of like being in the background, like Brandy. But yeah, so you might notice that there's a little bit more assertiveness that comes up for you. You might notice that you're taking initiative on things, or, you know, just wanting to kind of be in charge of something because you have, you know, with your big picture perspective, have identified, oh, this is a better way we can do it, or this is something new that we should try, or this is just an improvement we can make. So for your reading, I am using the Light Seers Tarot and the Sacred Rebels Oracle deck. And the first card of your reading is, ooh, Two of Pentacles. So you are in a time where you're really kind of finding or reestablishing some balance. You know, you're trying to figure out which way do I want to go? And it's not like a big shift in life. It might be like, do I want to start running, or do I want to do yoga? It's almost like being, gosh, I'm trying to think of like an analogy. It feels like being, I used to live in Arizona, and in the summertime they would have these misters, over like the patio areas. If you ate outside, or if you were walking inside. And so these misters would blow this like cool water on you, but if you kind of got out of reach of the misters, it was like really, really hot because it's Arizona. And so sometimes you could get in this in-between spot where it was like you were half cooled off and like half really hot. And so that's what it feels like to me, like you are literally like right in the middle of something, and you're just like, there's not this urgency to shift. Just like with her, she's kind of figuring out a way to balance both of these things, this purse and this I don't know, kind of like magical cloud pentacle thing. Like she's just really kind of in the middle of it, figuring out like, okay, which, you know, where does this feel comfortable? How do I want to balance this? So it's really just an awareness of the ability to rebalance things, not an urgency like, oh, I have to get things back in balance. It's just maybe because of the quiet stillness that we've all got to experience, you know, being self-quarantined, or if you're in a place that's, you know, that you have to shelter in place, or just doing social distancing, it's giving you the opportunity to become aware of the things that, you know, you are feeling are a little bit out of balance. So that was your first card. The next card is Nine of Swords. So there's something going on that you really feel like you have to be vigilant about. You know, she's got this small fence, and she's got her wand, and it's, you know, it looks like there's some fire at the top, but there's really not. And even the look on her face, she's not on guard, but she is very kind of aware that something's coming. And so I'm going to assume that this is tied together, that there's some kind of imbalance that's happening. And maybe this is external, maybe this is not it within you. And so if it's something external, this makes a lot more sense to me, that things are shifting, things are changing for all of us. Like the way that the world is, what we know of the world is changing a lot. And so that might have you kind of at this place where you're like a little bit skeptical, you're a little bit uncertain, but you're not worried. You are protecting yourself though, you know, which there's nothing wrong with that. Like, that is our responsibility to take care of and protect ourselves. And so the third card that I pulled for you is Ace of Pentacles, which is, the Ace cards are always really positive cards. So, you know, this, Aces are a card of new beginnings. So there's new resources that are coming to you. And that might be what the skepticism is about. Maybe someone is offering something to you, and there's a little bit of skepticism as far as like, okay, well, what do you want in return? Or is this too good to be true? Or why are you offering it? But just know that like time, money, resources, new jobs, a raise, opportunities, like these things that are coming, whatever they are in your life, these are from the divine. As we see these hands coming out of the sky, like this is really positive, you know, and there's nothing wrong with being skeptical about it. It's still going to come. Your skepticism is not going to block this blessing. You know, but in these times, like this is completely warranted to be a little skeptical and kind of like, okay, like I see this, but let me see how I feel. Like, what do I think? Let me ask some questions. Let me get some information. But yeah, there's money, time, resources. There's something of value that is coming for you in this new moon cycle. There's cat hair everywhere from this little girl. So the card that I pulled for you from the Sacred Rebels Oracle deck is number 34, and it's in the world, not of the world. And this imagery is just so in the traditional tarot, the card for Aquarius is the star. And if you're familiar with that, she has one foot in the water and one foot on the ground. And when we look at this card, she's very much like part of the water and part of the wildlife. Like in her hair, there's all these little, you know, like salmon seeds, and she's in the water. They're swimming around her. She's just hanging out, being this river goddess that she is. There's all these, you know, trees behind her. So, you know, you are very aware, as an Aquarius, you are very aware that you are kind of torn between two worlds. This is not anything that's like new to you. This isn't anything strange. And so I think if nothing else, this is really confirmation, validation that, you know, while you're kind of rebalancing some things, if new things come up that you weren't expecting and you're a little bit skeptical, there's nothing wrong with that. That is perfectly fine because you exist in two different worlds. You know, you have to look at things as far as like, okay, is this normal for this part of my world? Is this normal for this part of my world? And just kind of giving yourself the time and space to integrate all of this, you know, all of these changes that are coming in, you know, this new resources, being unsure about it, you know, balancing or being aware of a balance that needs to happen. And, you know, it's always a positive thing when we try to integrate or make space or make room or, just learn how to kind of flow between the two worlds that we live in. So that was your reading, Aquarius. I hope you have a really positive new moon, and that you are staying safe out there, you're staying healthy, you're washing your hands, you're able to socially distance yourself and stay healthy. And yeah, happy new moon in Aries, and I will see you soon. Bye.